As the Battle of the Bulge rages, the tip of the German spear, Piper's battle group, is racing to reach the River Meuse, the halfway point to his goal of Antwerp, within 24 hours. Hitler has made his instructions to Piper clear. Be ruthless in your pursuit, take no prisoners, and bring me Antwerp. With communications in shambles, the 291st Combat Engineers are secluded and out of touch. The tiny unit is unaware that the deadly tip of Hitler's enormous force is already at their doorstep. Pergrin is at a crossroads. His 291st Engineers are a support unit, not a combat unit. And they are certainly no match in manpower or firepower against the thousands of SS troops and hundreds of German tanks. But unwilling to do nothing, Pergrin realizes that fate has handed his 291st one critical asset. Geography. The terrain between Piper and Antwerp is cut by an extensive network of rivers and streams. Driven by necessity to capture large fuel depots en route to Antwerp, Piper must cross those rivers and streams. And to do so, he will need intact bridges. And that will be his Achilles heel. So begins one of the great cat-and-mouse games of World War II. The 291st, on their own initiative, form a seemingly impossible plan. Pergrin, guessing at Piper's route, breaks up his 291st into small squads and sends them racing ahead of Piper's speeding armor to mine and then blow those critical bridges to smithereens in the hopes that it will delay Piper long enough for the major Allied armies to catch up and annihilate his massive force before they can reach Antwerp. On the afternoon of December 17th, Joachim Piper and his massive battle group are racing towards the small hamlet of Stavelo and the bridge over the Emblev, critical to his capture of Antwerp by tomorrow evening.